Hello everyone, today we're going to talk about RedixArt and its implementation. So let's first see how RedixArt works and then we will see the implementation. So in RedixArt, we sort the numbers digit by digit. Now we can do that in two ways, either from most significant digit to least significant digit or from least significant digit to most significant digit. So in this video, we're going to sort numbers from least significant digit to most significant digit. In RedixArt, the actual sorting of digits can be done by any of the stable sorting algorithm. So in this video, we will implement RedixArt by using counting sort as the subroutine for sorting numbers by digits. So here we have an array of 7 numbers and we're gonna sort it using RedixArt. So first we will sort by ones place in the number. So first we will sort by the last digit of the numbers. So this red column. So we will sort by this first. So after first pass through counting sort, the last digit of the numbers are sorted. So this part in the green is now sorted. Now this entire input array will be our input for the next iteration of counting sort. So after second pass through counting sort, numbers are sorted by their last two digits. So what you see in this green box, this is sorted. So last two digits are sorted now. Now this entire array will be our input for the third and last iteration of counting sort. So after third pass through counting sort, our entire input array is completely sorted. Now here is another example of RedixArt. In this case, not all the numbers have same number of digits. So 170 have 3 digits, but 2 only have 1 digit. So we can treat 2 as 002 and 45 as 045. And 66 as 066 and so on. So first we will sort by ones place and after that this will become our input array for second iteration of counting sort. So after sorting by ones place, this is our input array for the second iteration of counting sort. In second iteration of counting sort, we will sort by tens place. So after sorting by tens place, this will be our input array for the next iteration of counting sort. In third iteration of counting sort, we will sort by hundreds place. So this will be our array after sorting through counting sort 3 times. And this is completely sorted. And one more thing about RedixArt is that it is a stable sorting algorithm, which means it preserves the order of elements that have the same key value. Now let's talk about how to implement RedixArt. So first of all, we have to find out the maximum number from the given input array, because we will have to call counting sort as many times as the number of digits in the maximum number. So in the above example, the maximum number in the given input array was 802. So here we are first getting the maximum number for the input array. And then we call counting sort as long as, so here we call the counting sort as long as when maximum number divided by exp is greater than 0. So initially exp will be 1, then it will become 10, then 100, then 1000 and so on. So in our case, maximum number in the array is 802. So we can only divide it 3 times, as 802 does not have thousands digit. So in this example, we will call counting sort 3 times. So that's why we need to first get the maximum number. And then this loop will call the count sort algorithm that many times, as long as we can divide by exp and that division is greater than 0. So in the count sort function, we basically implement the counting sort algorithm, which we discussed in the last video. So we create a count array and we output array size will be n, and count array size will be 10 because we are dealing with decimal number system. So and to make sure in each pass of counting sort, the count array starts with 0. So we will fill the count array with 0 first. Now here is the important part. When we increment the count of number, So first we have to extract the digit from the number. So this is how we do it. So to extract the one place from this number 802, so if you divide 802 by 1 and divide it by 10 and take a remainder, it will be 2. So this is our ones place in this number. And to get the tens place number, which is 0 in this case, so if you divide 802 by 10, which will be 80, and if you divide it again by 10 and take a remainder, it will be 0. So this is how we can get the second last digit of the number. Now to get the number in the hundreds place, we have to divide it by 100. So if you divide it by 100, it will be 8. And if you divide it by 10 and get a remainder, it will be 8. So this is how we can extract the individual digits of a number. So if you have to extract the ones place, divide it by 1 and then divide it by 10 and take a remainder. If you want to get the number at tens place, divide it by 10 and divide it by 10 and take a remainder. And if you want to get the number at 100 place, divide it by 100 and then divide it by 10 and take a remainder. So this is what we are doing here in the count sort. So initially exp will be 1, so we will divide it by 1. In the second iteration exp will be 10, so we will divide it by 10. In the third iteration exp will be 100, so we will divide it by 100. In the fourth iteration it will be thousands, like this. So that's how we can divide and get the count of and increment the count at the right place in the count array, basically. And then we are summing the count. This is how the counting sort works. So first you increment the count, and then you sum the count, and then you place the element at correct position in the output array. So we have the count in the count array, and then we decrement the count there in the count array. And finally, we are copying the elements from the output array to the input array, so that in the next iteration, this will be our input array. So now let's see the full implementation. So here we have radix sort implementation. So first we are calling the radix sort, which basically gets the maximum number. And in the loop, we are calling the count sort. And we are moving from least significant digit to most significant digit in this example. So maximum function is there, which will return the maximum number in the input array. And then the count sort function, which basically first increment the count at the correct place, then sum the count, and finally places the element at correct position in the output array, and then copy the output array elements into the given input array. So if I run this code now, we can see whether this implementation works correctly or not. So let's run this code. So our input array was this. So after first iteration of counting sort, this will become our input array. So it have sorted on the ones place. Now in the second iteration, it will sort by tens place. So after second iteration, this will be our array. And in the third iteration of counting sort, it will sort by 100 place, and this will be our final output by third iteration of counting sort. So this is how counting sort works. Now let's put a breakpoint and see how it increments the element in count array. So let me put a breakpoint here, and let's run it in debugger. Let's clean out this. Let's run it in debugger now. So initially count array will be 00 because we are filling it with 0. And now we will iterate over the input array and fill the and increment the count in the count array. So first element is 170. So if you divide it by 1 and then divide it by 10 and take a remainder, the result will be 0. So at 0 position, we will increment by 1. So if I execute it, so at 0 place, 1 is incremented. Now next element is 45. So for this, the ones place is 5. So we will go at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and increment 1 here at this location. So if we move forward, it will increment 1 there. And again for 75, because the ones place is 5, so it will increment again here, so it will become 2. So next element is 90, so ones place is 0, so it will increment 1 here, so it will become 2. Now next number is 802, so ones place is 2, so it will increment 1 at this location. So if we move forward, it will increment 1 there. And next element is 4, so it will increment 1 by here. And then next element is 2, so ones place is 2, so it will increment 1 here at this location, so it will become 2. And the last element is 66, so ones place is 6, so it will increment 6 1 here, so 0 1 2 3 4 5 6, so it will increment by 1 here at this location. And then we are simply summing the count, and while putting the element at correct position we are doing the same thing. So we will get the count from the count array and decrement by 1, and finally we will decrement the count. So this is how counting sort works, and this is all about the implementation of Redix sort. Now let's talk about the complexity of Redix sort. So in terms of space requirement, it's same as counting sort. It requires an output array of size n and the count array of size k, where k is the radix of the number. So in our case it will be 10, because we are dealing with decimal number system. If you are dealing with alphabet, so it will be 26 for alphabet letters, and for binary it will be 2, because 0 and 1 are only possible values there, so it will be 2. Now in terms of runtime analysis, because Redix sort applies counting sort for each of the p position of digits in the data, Redix sort runs in p times the runtime complexity of counting sort. So it will be bigger of pn plus pk, and if you remove the constant part, it will be bigger of pn. Now here is important thing. So suppose you have to sort this array. Now it have 1, 2, 3, 5 elements, and the largest element is very big. So for the above input data, Redix sort will have to do call counting sort 10 times. So Redix sort will call counting sort 10 times, because the maximum number have 10 digits. So as number of digits increases the input data, the performance of Redix sort will get worse. So Redix sort performs well only when the number of digits for the input data is small. So even though the Redix sort runtime complexity is linear time, it does not perform very well if the number of digits increase in the input data, because it have lot of overhead of extracting digits and copying arrays. So if you see in the implementation, we copy the output array back to input array, the initial input array. So if you call counting sort 10 times, we will copy the elements 10 times. And also here we are doing a lot of maths, so we are dividing the array data by exp, then we are again dividing by 10 and get a reminder. Then here also in the output array we are doing the same thing. So there is a lot of overhead, and if the number of digits in the Redix sort increases, the performance of Redix sort decreases. So it's good only for small numbers. So that's all about Redix sort and its implementation, and you can get the code for Redix sort from here.